So anyway, I did want to ask about the health effects, because in your negatives, I didn't say anything about health.
Health of the sulfur?
Whatever is being proposed to be...
So we looked at sulfur in the stratosphere, and my original list had enhanced acid rain, because when it falls out, it's got to go through the troposphere.
Uh-huh.
But we calculated how much it would be, and compared to the acid rain that we have today, a byproduct of burning fossil fuels, it wouldn't be very much extra. There might be, I mean, it's not good to breathe sulfuric acid, but compared to what we have now, the buffering capacity of the land, it wouldn't really be a significant impact, so I sort of took that off. Now, if you use other chemicals that are more dangerous, there have been some proposals to use titanium or aluminum or something. I don't know if anybody's done studies of the health effects. Certainly anything you put in the atmosphere is not going to be good for health, but
sure.
We thought food would be much more important than those small effects.
But there's a lot of research on the toxicity of aluminum and barium.
Well, I don't know why you bring up barium now, but it's...
Well, because it's in Dr. Keith's paper, the photophoretic levitation of aerosol particles. Those discs, it's a top layer aluminum oxide, then aluminum metal.
According to that, they would never fall down. They'd be levitated forever. So.
Well, until the sun goes down. So in any case, it would be a large amount injected into the atmosphere, and there are many...
I don't know, yeah, except for that paper, which sort of
got one
published,
that,
and nobody's really studying, that I know of, massive injections of other chemicals. It's cloud brightening is salt from the ocean, which is there anyway, and the stratosphere, most people are focusing on sulfate aerosols.
Well, my first reference in my paper is the Pope article from 2012. They talk about how sulfates are ineffective. They should be using aluminum and barium.
Okay, you have to ask them.
Yeah, okay. But I would think it would be a good thing to concentrate on health.
Well,
because Dr. Keith was asked about the health thing back in 2010.
Yeah, he says excess sulfur would kill a lot of people.
Well, when he was answering a question about aluminum,
yeah,
because he was talking about putting so many megatons in the atmosphere, and he said that there's very little. The only research he'd done on it, he hadn't published, and that was back in 2010. And we haven't heard a peep from him since.
You'll have to ask him.
Yeah.
I don't know of any work on that.
So did you get to read my paper? I know you didn't like the font.
I still have it, but I didn't.
Okay,
I didn't have time.
Let me know.
If you want people to pay attention, you should submit it to a peer-reviewed journal so people can give you some feedback.
I will. This is for the conference, it's. I mean, all my references are peer-reviewed.
So, sure, but still, your ideas.
Oh, I know.
Yeah.
Well, my idea is. There's literature saying that sulfates are ineffective because they coagulate and fall out of the sky,
yeah,
and it's been proposed by more than one person to put aluminum and barium in nanoparticulate form into the atmosphere, and there's a bunch of science and literature showing how those are highly toxic, and
so send it to a journal that. Where people, health effects of air pollution or something like that, and where people with expertise, unlike me, who can evaluate that.
Yeah, okay. But
I've got many other reasons.
I know you have many things to do, but I would request to add in your list health.
Okay. I just wanted to say, I've got many other reasons why it's a bad idea. So
That's
not going to change my basic balancing.
All right. Okay. Thank you. Okay.